They are two Northern California mothers, and their names are on the lawsuit that may soon, once and for all, decide the issue of same-sex marriage. Tonight, Chris Perry and Sandy Steer are about to leave for Washington, D.C. to hear the arguments for and against same-sex marriage at the U.S. Supreme Court.
Before leaving, though, they talked with KCRA3's David Beenig about what they expect.
Chris Perry and Sandy Steer were calm and relaxed as they posed for pictures this afternoon, but say 5 days from now, when they climb the steps of the U.S. Supreme Court, their emotions might come to the surface.
Well, absolutely. We're anxious about it because it's so important.
Perry is a children's issues advocate, Steer an IT manager for Alameda County. They live in Berkeley and together have raised four sons, now ages 18 to 24. 4 years ago, same-sex marriage supporters selected Perry and Steer, along with a couple from Burbank, to be the plaintiffs in a lawsuit attacking California's same-sex marriage ban, Proposition 8.
Our courts are supposed to protect our constitutional rights.
The couples won at a trial court in San Francisco and at an appeals court, but always knew that the case was likely headed for the nation's highest court. Only their lawyers will speak at next Tuesday's hearing.
Our role is to be there to listen and to represent gay people in California.
Perry and Steer hope the court will strike down all same-sex marriage bans across the country, but say it'll still be a victory if the court limits its decision to just California's Prop 8.
We feel very confident that we have a strong case, and we're really very hopeful.
With their names on the case that might be a landmark for the issue of gay rights, the couple is now starting to think about putting their names on wedding invitations.
It'll be really enjoyable to spend time calmly figuring out how we would like to be married. But before that, we need to finish the job we set out to do.
Now, after next Tuesday's hearing, Perry and Steer will have to wait about 3 months for the Supreme Court's decision. They say, fortunately, two of their sons are seniors in high school, so there are proms and graduations to plan. Plenty to keep them busy between now and June.
They will be sending out some invitations. So did they talk about how they feel, regardless of the Supreme Court's decision, about how much has changed since voters passed Prop 8? Many other states now have passed gay marriage. Polls show that in California and across the nation, more people are accepting gay marriage.
They do say they're encouraged by these polls and by their trends, and they say that if it came to the polls again here in California, if it went back to the ballot box, chances are that it would win, and that's what the politicians have planned if they lose at the Supreme Court, but they say they just don't want to wait. Mm-hmm. They want this issue decided now, and they think they can win.
David, thank you. We want to remind our viewers that David will be traveling to Washington, D.C. to bring us comprehensive coverage of the Supreme Court's ruling on Prop 8 and the arguments. Look for David Beenig's live reports next week from the nation's capital.